Over my career, I've seen that teams that don't perform as well are run by leaders who are stuck in old ways. They don't listen to their team's ideas and suggestions. That disconnect creates tension that trickles down into people's work. Employees show up to do their job and earn their paycheck, but they're stressed and tired. Good leaders don't all lead in the same way, but they do understand the importance of being open-minded. If you want to lead boldly, take a look at what is working in your organization. Which teams are running effectively? Then get to the foundation of what is making things work so well for them. Look at whether you could model parts of their way of working in your own team. This is what I mean by creating a new definition. Scrap the old ways that aren't working, find what does work in your organization, and figure out how to replicate that model and put your own spin on it. At an organizational level, you can enjoy success by rethinking old definitions. At Mancini, instead of building our firm to emulate traditionally successful names, we have leaned into what makes us unique and different, and we keep doing more of that. Just because other people are running their organization in a certain way doesn't mean we have to do the same. It's actually what we do differently that makes us stronger. That's bold leadership. Setting a new vision, not listening too much to the naysayers, focusing on your people and how you can be successful together, and bringing everyone along with you. If you need guiding words for this approach to leadership, remember flexibility and innovation. Making big changes means being flexible enough to let go of the old ways and being excited about and open to innovative new ideas. A new opportunity for my team.